Now, on behalf of the CITU Secretariat, I welcome you all to the 16th conference of CITU, which is being held in this historic city of Chennai. I welcome the WFTU President, Michael Mukwaiba, and also all our central trade unions who are here, and all our CITU comrades and the people of Tamil Nadu in general. So comrades, you know, this is the third time we are holding a CITU conference in Chennai. First, when comrade BTR and PR, they were alive, our founder president and founder general secretary, at that time the fourth conference was held in 1979. Then the 11th conference in 2003, and now this 16th conference 2020. They have made all very good arrangements here, and I think we'll have a very successful conference. And on this occasion, Tapan has already said that this conference is being held in the Golden Jubilee year of CITU, and also the centenary year of the first central trade union in our country, the AITUC. And another occasion related to this city of Chennai is of the great freedom fighter, Singaruvel Chettiar. And he was the, probably we all remember, that he was the person who first hoisted the red flag on the occasion of May Day in 1923. That was the first time the red flag was hoisted on the occasion of May Day. And he was also among the first few communists of our country. So this, we hope that it will be a historic occasion for our CITU. And from here, we'll be able to take some concrete decisions for the heightening of the struggle. And this conference we are also holding soon after the general strike on 8 January, which was a magnificent strike where crores of workers have participated on the demand of the workers, the 12-point charter of demands. And in addition, we have added the 13th point, the opposing, demanding the repeal of the CAA and NPR and NRC process. So on this, not only the workers, but also the peasants, the agricultural workers, the rural workers, and all sections of the society have extended their support. Not only extended their support, they have come out onto the streets in very huge demonstrations and protests, dharnas, etc., roadblocks, rasta roko, rail block, etc. So this conference, we have to also discuss how to take this joint struggle, a united struggle, forward so that we can compel the BJP government led by Modi to withdraw these anti-worker, anti-people and anti-national policies. So this conference will be passing in this inaugural session itself. First, the president of WFTU will address, and all the leaders of the central trade unions also will address this inaugural session. And in addition to that, we'll also pass some important resolutions. We all know, despite the struggles, the government is going ahead with its anti-democratic attitude. We have seen the CAA, despite the huge protests, particularly by the young and by the students, the BJP government is not only resorting to violence and oppression, but the Home Minister, yesterday he has announced, those who want to protest, you can protest, but we will go ahead with the CAA. So that is the attitude of the government. So on that, condemning the CAA strongly, we will pass a resolution. In addition, as we are struggling in our country, the working class, similarly, on similar demands, the working class is on the struggle path in the entire world. Particularly in France, we have seen that from 5th December, the rail and road transport workers, supported by hundreds of thousands of workers from other sections, are on strike. And we have to express our solidarity and support to the struggling workers of France, the railroad workers. And also similarly, we'll pass a resolution against the attacks of the government, particularly on the JNU students who have been opposing the fee hike and also opposing the CAA. On both these fronts, the government has targeted the university students, particularly the JNU students, who stand for progressive values, secular values, and democracy to protect our constitution. So these three important resolutions will be passing in the inaugural session itself. So first, I'll read out the resolution in solidarity of the fighting workers of France. 16th conference of CITU being held in Chennai on 23rd to 27 January 2020 conveys revolutionary greetings to the rail and road transport workers of France who are on strike since 5th December 2019. On behalf of the working class of India, the conference extends solidarity to the striking workers of France. The French rail and road transport workers are on strike for over 50 days, demanding the withdrawal of the changes in the pension policy in the name of the pension reforms by the reactionary Macron government. The government has decided to combine the existing 42 different types of pensions into one. The changes will result in severe reduction in the pension benefits. Workers will have to work for more years but will get lower pension. The government is also considering increase in the age of retirement from 62 to 64, which the French workers are strongly opposing. While the call for the strike was given by the unions of the rail and road transport workers, many other sections of workers and employees, including nurses, lawyers, police, and others, joined the strike on 5th December as well as on 9th January. Huge demonstrations are being held in various cities across the country. In several places, police resorted to attacks on the protesting workers, injuring many. The Macron government's policies of reform since 2017 have been attacking the rights and benefits of the workers in France by cutting down their hard-won welfare benefits. They have led to the discontent among the people who are coming out in big struggles. The Yellow Vest movement is continuing since more than a year. Since November 2018, hundreds and thousands of people have been demonstrating in Paris and other cities in France every weekend. The movement started against the increase in taxes, but later on included many other demands of the common people. Yellow Vest also joined the workers' demonstrations since 5th December. Despite the difficulties due to the strike of the rail and road transport workers, people in France are supporting the strike. Various sections of people have expressed their solidarity to the strike. Workers, especially in Europe, see the strike as a struggle that would have a positive impact on their lives too. Because, as WFTU General Secretary George Mavrikos said, the European Union and the International Monetary Fund and the governments following their diktats have been hitting the workers' social security benefits and pensions in the name of austerity measures and creating huge private funds. It's not only the workers of Europe, working class all over the world, wherever the neoliberal policies are being implemented, including in India, are facing such attacks on their pensions, wages, and working conditions. Such attacks by the capitalists and the governments, which come to power with workers' votes but work for the big corporates, have further increased since the global crisis, which still continues after more than a decade. The capitalists want to maximize their profits by curtailing the benefits of the workers. These can be defended only by strengthening united struggles of the working class, standing in solidarity with the workers wherever they are fighting these attacks, while conveying its fullest support to the fighting workers of France and trade unions leading the struggle. This 16th conference calls upon the working class of India to extend support in all possible ways, including financial support to the French workers. Comrades, the resolution is before you. I request all of you who support the resolution to raise their hands and support the resolution. Thank you. Yeah.